Good afternoon, guys. It is July 5th, 2021. Well, this video, I want to talk about just some things that I have had on my mind and a little bit about me and just what I'm seeing in our culture, in our society today. Noticing that a lot of people just are not using common sense anymore. It's not as common, it's not as popular, whatever, you know. Gotten to this point where I think that people just have become like, I don't know what word to use, but I don't want to say ignorant, but I would say just not as not as open as they used to be, you know, and then the other thing is, like, everybody wants to, like, be the same and be like everybody else. Everybody wants to be, you know, up with the times and have the latest and greatest with everything. Everybody wants to, you know. And for me, I'm kind of like, first of all, I'm 22 years old. I was born in 99. But, you know, so I am older. I'm not, like, ancient by any means. But I'm older than the sun, you know, I just like the older way of doing things. I don't like to use, high-tech items at all. I don't. I mean, I have Apple products, but I just use them for uploading to YouTube and surfing the internet and stuff. I don't really use computers for a ton of stuff, really. I use a paper calendar and write down every event in a paper calendar. I write notes down on paper. I never type anything into a computer. I just don't. I mean, I'm somebody who just likes things simple. And, you know, the old way of doing things. But also, I've noticed that a lot of people, like, look down upon people who don't have a college degree, who don't have, you know, anything like that, and they just look down on them. And people who work with their hands and do repairs, pick up trash, clean, all that stuff, people just look down on them like they don't even matter. You know, that includes plumbers, electricians, HVAC people, you know. I want to ask you this. Do you know how to fix those things and how to do those things? If you don't, and you hire somebody to do it, why are you looking down on them? They are doing you a good service by coming out to your home and doing plumbing or whatever. It used to be back in the old days, a long, long, long time ago, like even before my time, where people just fixed things themselves and they did what they could, you know? And then if they really couldn't figure it out, then they would get some help. And it seems like nobody's willing to do that nowadays. You know, just simple repairs. Simple things, you know, a lot of people are just like, oh, well, I don't know how to do that. And I'm not, you know, putting anybody down who doesn't know how to do that. I mean, you just don't know what you don't know. But, you know, I think it is important skills, you know, to be able to change a tire or do simple maintenance on your car or change a light bulb or, you know, change parts in your toilet or, you know, just simple things like that, unclog your drain if you can. And I understand that there's a level where, you know, you just need a professional, I get that, but, you know, back in the old days, they just used to do things pretty simply, and they didn't really worry about calling anybody out, you know. Especially a long, long time ago, you didn't even have people like that, you know, in the days before electricity and stuff. If your equipment, you know, broke or had a problem, you figured it out, and you fixed it, so. You know, so there's a lot of things that I'm noticing, you know. Do not think that a person who hasn't gone to college or didn't do very well in school is not smart. That is wrong. Do not think that. I can tell you one thing, I'm not, you know, not trying to put anybody down at all, but I know some people who didn't even graduate high school and have a lot more common sense and a lot more, you know, knowledge to know things and know how to do things than people who have huge college degrees. I've seen it. I don't have a college degree. I graduated high school a couple years ago. I think it was like 3 or 4 years ago, somewhere in there. But I didn't feel confident in school. I didn't feel confident in that. But, you know, I feel really good working with my hands, repairing things, HVAC work, working on appliances and plumbing, you know, fixing things like door hinges and all kinds of things like that. And a lot of those things people just think you're weird for doing. And it's just wrong. I mean, what would you do if something broke in your house and you couldn't even call anybody? Could you be able to figure it out and figure out how to do something? I mean, seriously. You know, So, I just think that people have kind of lost common sense, and not to mention, there's people that just have done flat-out dumb stuff that just makes no sense, and it makes you shake your head, and you're like, what was that person thinking, you know? Like, they're not even thinking about the consequences of later, they're not thinking about anything like that. You know, I don't know. It just bothers me. But, you know, we've gotta, like, get back to learning how to do things, learning how to, you know, do things yourself. And people wonder why we have all these labor shortages and, you know, food shortages and all this stuff. And it's because this isn't all, you know, the only cause of the problem, but it's because there's a lot of people that are not willing to go back to work and aren't willing to work in these areas. You know, and I'm not knocking people who have disabilities and stuff. I'm personally not really able to work quite yet. I'm getting there, but I'm not there yet. And so, I've never worked a job yet. And it's not that I don't want to, it's just I'm trying to be wise and be careful and, you know, think about what I can do because I have a lot of challenges learning and understanding things. But, you know, I'll eventually do something. You know, think about, like, if you rent an apartment, how many times do you call maintenance out for little things? You know, if you didn't have, you know, maintenance to come out, what would you do? What could you do to fix things? And we rent this house, but, you know, I don't feel the need to call our landlord or our maintenance person out for everything, you know. If it's something major or something we can't really figure out on our own, then yeah, we'll call them. But, you know, I've had, you know, toilets act up. I've been able to replace parts in the toilets. I've had, you know, certain things like that happen. I've had bathroom sink drains have some issues. I've been able to fix those. So there's just a lot of things that you can do yourself that are pretty simple. You know. So learn how to do these things and everything, and don't look down on these people who are doing this stuff for a living. Just don't. They have skills, and they're doing a job that they enjoy. Well, most of them probably enjoy it. Some of them might not, but they're just doing it just because they have to. But for the most part, I think a lot of these people enjoy these jobs. So do not look down on them. On plumbers and stuff, what would you do if you had a major plumbing problem and there was no plumbers? Who would you call? Who would know how to do that? I mean, seriously, people. So, you know, what if your air conditioning went out or your heat went out? You know, would you know how to fix that? I'm not saying that you can't fix it yourself, because in some cases you can. But, you know, some of that stuff is like major, major work. Like, you know, you had to get the unit replaced or whatever. So, you know, don't look down on these people that do these jobs. You know, they are doing you a service that is absolutely vital. You know, don't look down on the people who, you know, work on drain lines and on sewers and on roads and everything, because it's a dirty job. Don't look down on that. Those people don't deserve that. They are working very, very, very hard to provide you a nicer, safer, and more convenient community and home. So, don't look down on them. Don't treat them like they don't matter. But also, you know, I think people have gotten away from, like, doing things physically and doing things with their hands, and they just think, oh, well, I can do computer stuff, and I can do this stuff, and I can do that stuff, and it's nothing really, like, hands-on productive. And I'm not saying that those things are wrong, and I'm not saying that there's not a place for those. But what I am saying is, I think we're kind of in this culture, we're not really paying attention to the mechanical needs and the hands-on skills that, you know, people had long before there was ever computers and, you know, stuff like we have today. So, you know, it used to be like appliances and stuff, like, here's a fan right here. They're not made like they used to be. It used to be, you know, if you had one break or something, you'd take it to a little shop, and, you know, the guy could look at it, and he can, you know, fix whatever was wrong with it, and, you know, give it back to you, and you're back up and running. Nowadays, these are, like, virtually disposable. They're not even made to be repaired or to be serviced. Although I do attempt to, you know, service and repair things as much as I can, even if they're supposed to be disposable. And you can get mad at me all you want, saying, oh, that's not safe or whatever, but really, I'm not going to just throw something away without at least attempting to fix it. If it doesn't work out and it doesn't fix, okay, I'll throw it away. You know, but I always want to try, because, you know, save some money, save something from being thrown out into the landfill. You know, all that stuff. It just seems like nowadays, you know, people just don't really think about that as important. And it is, you know. What would happen if you couldn't get a hold of those things for as cheap and they were more expensive? Would you want to, you know, make sure it lasts because you paid so much more money for it? You know? I think so, you know. I have, you know, a couple Kirby vacuum cleaners that are like about 20 years old. And, you know, they still run perfect. I mean, they're meant to last for a very long time like that to begin with, but, you know, I'm gonna continue to repair them until they absolutely cannot be repaired anymore. Which, it takes a long time for them to get to that point, but, you know, it's just worth, you know, having some knowledge about this stuff to keep things in good shape and to know how to live, you know, how to grow your own food, how to take care of, you know, yourself and take care of your home and take care of your Your thing, because we're all just so busy with everything else. There are people that have like so much brain knowledge and stuff, and they can tell you all about, whatever, but they have no idea how to, change a light bulb, or they have no idea how to fix a leaking pipe, or they have no idea how to do any of that. So don't think that one thing is more valuable than another. There's a lot that does have value in the college degree aspect of things, but it is not a necessity for everything in life. And what I'm wanting to do, I don't think a college degree would be necessary. I would like to get into home maintenance or home cleaning or, commercial cleaning or whatever. And, I had no interest in going into college anyway, because my brain just burns out on education. I mean, it just wears out. I can't absorb things that well, but I'm very visual and I can take things and take them apart, put them back together, rebuild, repair, and stuff like that, So, I have no need for, a college degree
necessarily.
for most of that stuff.
At least not that I'm aware of. But
For the most part, I wouldn't think
you
you
would, because
it's just hands-on skills. It's a trait. Of course, I would, need to be trained and make sure that I know things correctly. But, I'm not looking for anything spectacular. I'm just looking to get things done. With my hands, I enjoy that. Anyway, that's just something that I wanted to talk about. It seems like nowadays, people do belittle all this stuff, and my mom told me one time, "Son, you're an old soul." It might be true. It might be true. I don't know, but I just don't move with the times that well. It takes me a long time to move with the times. I don't even know half the stuff on the internet. It's just, or half the stuff in the technology world, or anything like that. And I have very little interest in that. Just not a very tech-savvy person. But, I like to be hands-on and getting stuff done. With my hands and physically and everything like that. I love that. So, anyway, please like, comment, and subscribe.